Now, I know in the span of our relationship, things haven't always been easy. There were times in the past when we second-guessed ourselves and thought maybe this wasn't the right fit for us. But one thing that has never changed is my love for you. I have never stopped and will never stop loving you. Yeah, the ink must stain my skin. And my jeans may all be ripped. I'm not perfect, but I swear I'm perfect for.
Thought that a chance encounter in the summer of 2002 on a small dance floor in Sunnyvale, California would lead us here, the Boathouse in Central Park in New York City, exchanging marriage vows before our beloved family and friends. Now I can truly say that I am happy with the man I've become, and I owe that happiness to you.
I wish you and Patrick the best of everything. I wish you success and abundant life. I wish you love, joy, and happiness through all the years that you will be together. I love you both.
When you're sick, I want to be the person who takes care of you. When you're hungry, I won't cook for you because I don't know how. But I'll place a seamless order for you in a heartbeat. What I'm trying to say is that while I know I can't always be your everything, I just want to continue to be that person you can always depend on. I'm so honored to call you my best friend and your future husband. I'm so excited to see what this new journey has in store for the both of us. And I will cherish you and love you as long as I'm alive. I love you so much.
I'm not perfect, but I swear I'm perfect for you.
Alvin, I give you this ring, a bond made in metal.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Always remind you, I love you, and am by your side.
Always remind you, I love you, and am by your side.
Now that Alvin and Patrick have given themselves to each other through the exchanging of rings, by the power vested in me, by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husbands united in love. You may seal your vows with a kiss.
Today to be very fortunate to witness this union and to share their love. And with that, I'd like to toast the very, very handsome and very stylish couple here today.
Alvin and Patrick, I wish you a lifetime of laughter, love, and endless success. Please raise your glasses for the lovely couple to Alvin and Patrick.
You're my treasure. You're my treasure.
Loving can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes. But it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel alive. We keep this love in a photograph. We made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, and time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone. Wait for me to come home. Loving can heal. Loving can mend your soul. And it's the only thing that I know.
Said it again, my heart's emotion ever.
quick, let it come down, crash. Let the sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent, 'cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you what I've strung together, the very first words of a lifelong love letter. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose.
Thank you.
family and friends, first and foremost, on behalf of Alvin and Patrick, I welcome you to the Boathouse at New York's iconic Central Park. We are gathered here today by the grace of God, not to witness the beginning of what will be, but rather to celebrate what already is. It is rare for all of us to gather in such a unique place. You have the steely ruckus city surrounding the luscious greenery of this park. But it is much more notable a rarity to encounter the lives of two loving and beautiful people. Even more rare is to unite as one. Patrick and Alvin have invited all of you because of the bonds that tie you together. You have in one way or another learned together, worked together, laughed with one another, and grown together as family and friends. This is why they want more than anything but to share this day with all of you. Alvin, will you have Patrick to be your partner, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Patrick, will you have Alvin to be your partner, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Alvin, Patrick, today you choose each other before your loving family and friends to begin the next chapter of your lives together as husbands. By doing so, you are creating a new union, a renewed commitment, and a new sense of family, one that will undoubtedly be joined all who are present here today. Now it is time to forget all the stresses of planning this day and just embrace the moment and the love that you have for each other, and all the love and the joy that your family and friends bestow upon you. At this time, Patrick and Alvin will be expressing their vows to you of love. Patrick.
After almost 13 years, we're finally making it official. I honestly can't believe we're standing here in front of all of our family and friends, many of whom have traveled thousands of miles to share this special day with us. It's a true testament of the great relationships that we've built over the years. And speaking of relationships, it is my relationship with you that I value most in life. When we first met, I was somewhat at a crossroads in my life. I had just graduated high school, moved to California, and I was just getting over a really bad breakup with an ex. I was working at the mall, and I wasn't taking school very seriously. I really didn't know what I wanted in life. However, you pushed me and motivated me to want more. The reason why I am where I am today is mostly because of you. You saw what many others didn't, and I'll always be grateful for that. And I can't even begin to describe what an amazing person you are. You constantly put others in front of you. You give back to the community whenever you can. After work, you spend hours on end writing notes so that all of your patients are safe and taken care of. You truly have a heart of gold. And I know that there are times when you doubt yourself, but I want to let you know that you are the hardest working and most intelligent person I've ever met in my entire life. And when I do bust your chops, it's only because I want to feel as smart as you are. And when I get really competitive and rub it in your face when I win, it's because you're so good at everything. And if I can even have a fraction of your talent, I'd be set. Don't ever second guess or doubt yourself. You really are one of a kind. And I'd like to add, you are the greatest dad a dog could hope for, and I know that Biju loves you as much. I know she loves you as much as I do. Now I know in the span of our relationship, things haven't always been easy. There were times in the past when we second-guessed ourselves and thought maybe this wasn't the right fit for us. But one thing that has never changed is my love for you. I have never stopped and will never stop loving you. As long as we have that type of love, I think we can fight through anything, and we have. I want to continue to be the first person you call when you have good news or bad news. The first person you talk to when you're stressed out and need someone to vent to. When you're sick, I want to be the person who takes care of you. When you're hungry, I won't cook for you because I don't know how. But I'll place a seamless order for you in a heartbeat. What I'm trying to say is that while I know I can't always be your everything, I just want to continue to be that person you can always depend on. I'm so honored to call you my best friend and your future husband. I'm so excited to see what this new journey has in store for the both of us. And I will cherish you and love you as long as I'm alive. I love you so much.
All right. My beluga.
Oh my God.
Who would have thought that a chance encounter in the summer of 2002 on a small dance floor in Sunnyvale, California would lead us here, the Boathouse in Central Park in New York City, exchanging marriage vows before our beloved family and friends. For the almost 13 years in between, we've endured many highs, lows, twists and turns that would rival any of our favorite things. Roller coasters, Oscar-worthy films, or Bravo reality TV shows. Yet through it all, we've grown, not just as a couple, but also as individuals. And for the first time in my life, I can honestly say that I'm truly happy with the individual that I've become. And I owe that to you. For many years, I struggled a lot with finding my self-worth. Sorry. I struggled because of my fears. Fears of not being accepted for being gay. Fear of not being smart enough to become a physician. Fear of disappointing my parents and my family. But now I can truly say that I am happy with the man I've become. And I owe that happiness to you. So before I give you my vows, I want to take this time to say something to you that I don't get to do often, which is to thank you. Thank you for making me feel confident in my own skin when all I wanted to do was shed it completely. Thank you for lifting me up and making me laugh or smile with your funny gymnastics moves. Or your hilarious catchphrases during those times I felt down. Thank you for being so loving and affectionate, or what I say in Tagalog, malambing. Thank you for taking care of me through difficult times, the long and arduous work hours during residency, when I became ill and became the patient myself, and when I had to stay strong for my family when my dad passed away. You allowed me to cry and just be vulnerable, reminding me that it's gonna be okay. Thank you for showing me your persistence and determination and for accomplishing things when you just simply put your mind to it. And finally, thank you for allowing me to fully be myself. And now my promises to you as your husband. I promise to continue to be your best friend. I promise to always give you a kiss before I leave the house. I promise to tie your neckties when you need me to. I promise to wash my hands whenever we get home, especially after riding the subway. I promise to start our prayers when we take our seats on an airplane. I promise to support you, encourage you, and believe in you. I promise to build our home filled with great food, laughter, and lots of love. I promise to love you with actions, not just words. I promise to celebrate every milestone with you and walk beside you through every journey life takes us. I promise to always be a better me for us. And I promise to love you, need you, and be with you forever. I am so happy and blessed to be your husband. I cannot imagine a more fortunate existence.
Let us have Patrick's brother Alex and Alvin's sister Annalise join us for the lighting of the candle. Patrick and Alvin, take the flame from the candles which your siblings Alex and Annalise have lit and light the center unity candle. You will see that this center candle is larger than the other two, because it is your family that has been formed today, as you shared your vows and will be blending of all the love, traditions, and experiences you both have shared with your individual families. Can we please have Linda and Travis join us for the exchanging of the rings, also known as Adas. Coins, sorry. I said rings, but it is actually the coins. These coins are a reminder of good stewardship for all couples, that they will mutually support each other, their children, and the world around them. May God bless these coins and symbolize mutual support and responsibility. Patrick, repeat after me. I give you this as a pledge.
I give you this as a pledge.
Of my dedication to your welfare.
My dedication to your welfare.
The care of our home.
The care of our home.
And the well-being of our family.
And the well-being of our family.
Alvin, repeat after me. I give you this as a pledge.
I give you this as a pledge.
Of my dedication to your welfare.
Of my dedication to your
the care of our home.
The care of our home.
And the well-being of our family.
And the well-being of our family.
Alvin and Patrick, I invite your siblings Nico and Ariel to place a cord over you. This cord symbolizes an infinite bond of the love you share that keeps your relationship strong in the face of adversity and that you are now one in marriage. There we go.
My hair.
May this cord remind you to face your life together courageously and to be mutual in support of each other in carrying out your duties as a couple. May your love grow stronger and bind you closer together through the years. Now I'd like to invite Christian, who will be sharing a reading with us.
Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with a honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other. Not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding the room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. It is discovering what marriage can be at its best.
I now invite back Nico and Ariel for the removal of the cord. It is now time for the exchanging of the rings. Patrick, repeat after me. Alvin, I give you this ring, a bond made in metal.
Alvin, I give you this ring, a bond made in metal.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Always remind you that I love you and am by your side.
Always remind you that I love you and am by your side.
Alvin, repeat after me. I give you this ring, a bond made in metal.
I give you this ring, a bond made in metal.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Let its preciousness, its shine, and its weight.
Always remind you, I love you, and am by your side.
Always remind you, I love you, and am by your side.
Now that Alvin and Patrick have given themselves to each other through the exchanging of rings, by the power vested in me, by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husbands united in love. You may seal your vows with a kiss. Mr. Mario Binerau, Miss Tess Binerau!
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much.
Right by then, we have our mother and sisters of Alvin Diodoro, Miss L.B. Diodoro, Annalise Diodoro, and Arielle Diodoro! His maid of honor, Melissa Kanchanapome Levine. Let's give it up for Melissa, everybody. Getting us started with Alvin's best men. Give it up for Real Caporis! Our next best man, Make some noise for Jeffrey Amante! Now finishing up Alvin's best friend, make some noise for Jonathan Ocampo! Let's make some noise for Alvin's wedding party! Getting us started with Patrick's wedding party, his maid of honor, Erin Gorilla! Looking fabulous. Getting us started with our best friend. Give it up for Kid Ransom. Hey. Next up, make some noise for Jomar Lanzar. Last but not least, best man, make some noise for Chris Cole! Everybody make some noise for Patrick's wedding party! I need everybody to stand on their feet, and I have a few things to say matched up with a few very special songs. The couple got together in September of 2002. DJ. They got engaged in Sydney, Australia.
First things first, I'm really
Iggy Azalea is Australian, so we chose this song for them. On May 24th, 2015, which is today, right? They made it official here at the iconic Central Park here in New York City! Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome your newlyweds! Dr. Alvin Diadoro and Mr. Patrick Diadoro!
I've waited all my life.
cross this line to the only thing that's true. So I will not hide. It's time to try anything to be with you. All my life I've waited. This is true. I know when I go.
How they doing out there, everybody? How they doing out there?
Well, I have a very long speech prepared. Unfortunately, or very fortunate for you, probably, I left it in the hotel room. So I guess I'm just going to have to wing it. Some of you had known Patrick and Alvin as an individual, and some of you have known them as a couple. And you know, as a couple, they've been together for a very long time. 13 years. Their decision to wed is an affirmation of their desire to be together for a very long time. And I admire them for them, and I admire them for that decision. So, as a parent and Patrick's dad, I couldn't be more proud for both of them. So, So let's toast to Alvin and Patrick.
Okay, so for those who don't know me, my name is Melissa. Hi, everyone. You're going to make me lose my place on my phone. So I'm Alvin's maid of honor. Just 9 years ago, Alvin and I met in medical school in a small school called UCSF in San Francisco. And I had just moved up from LA. And I was really nervous because there were a ton of incredibly smart people who had traveled the world and worked at Genentech and went to Berkeley and was in a dance troupe, whatever. Whatever, you know, and I was petrified, and my biggest life challenge was in front of me, moving to SF because of this, and it was because on a daily basis, I had to see people carry Timbuktu bags, wearing clogs, and the worst of all, wearing fleece. And, yes, we all know. I know there's a lot of you from the Bay Area, but that is just, yes, yes. Best city ever. But let me tell you, fleece, not a fabric. No, 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 no. But I went up to the anatomy floor and, the smells overcome you, whatever. And I'm standing in front of this cadaver, and in walks this Filipino boy. He's carrying in his black leather LV bag. Everyone else is in scrubs, but Alvin's in a tailored shirt, dark gray jeans. And I was like, I have met my confidant. I have met my life savior in San Francisco, and all was well. So over the past 9 years, after that very fortuitous meeting in the anatomy lab. We grew and we evolved to become lifelong friends. And he, you know, Alvin, he's one of those really rare, fabulous friends. You know, it's like 11 a.m. and he's like down for happy hour. And I'm like, you know, girl, it is not happy hour yet. Maybe for us, but not yet. He will get up on the podium with you at DNA Lounge and push a girl off the podium just so, yeah. just so I have the space to lift my leg up this high, because he knows I can lift it up that high. And then when you fall off that podium, he's right there. He's right there to hold out a Gucci bag for you. For you to, you know, just in case you need it, just, you know, because, you know, we had a good night and I had to throw up in that bag, but it's okay. It's okay, you know, and sometimes in those moments, I really forget that Alvin's a little bit older than me. Just a little. And he's so wise and he's so understanding. And, you know, this weekend I turned to Elvie and I was like, it's really special for me to see you with your sisters and to see his kindness and his love, because I have been so fortunate to receive that in the past 9 years, and to see that with our friends and our patients and now with your sisters. And it's just been so special for me to experience, you know, your understanding, your love, and your kindness. And I don't think I could have gone through the past decade without your guidance, your friendship, and your love. But then Patrick entered the picture, and I no buts. I mean, but very fortunately, Patrick entered the picture. And I remember, you know, going into Alvin's apartment for the first time, and he showed me a picture of Patrick, and I was like, what? This has got to be your brother. Okay, we all were thinking that. Come on. Someone had to say it at this wedding, but, you know. And as much as they look so similar, they're pretty much opposites when it comes to the personality. And, you know, Alvin is a pediatrician, as we all know. And Patrick is, well, to be quite honest, I really don't know what you do. I know that you are amazing at Excel sheets. I know. Yes. This wedding does not exist without Excel, people. Let me tell you. And I know there's Amazon in that somewhere, but I know he's amazing at what he does. Alvin goes with the flow. Patrick is, to say the least, organized as hell. And I was having anxiety attacks. It was like 9:05, and I was like, shit, man, where is Mario? I'm supposed to be up there at 9:04 and 13 seconds. So, but, you know, over the years, I watched Alvin and Patrick's relationship develop, mature, and grow into what it is today. And through their relationship, they have really grown to be the most withstanding and understanding couples that I know. I have seen Patrick bring a level of maturity, of forgiveness, and of stability and self-acceptance and happiness in my dear friend, Alvin. And with their differing personalities, I knew that Patrick was it for Alvin. And so here we are today to be very fortunate to witness this union and to share their love. And with that, I'd like to toast the very, very handsome and very stylish couple here today. So may you have a life full of happiness, maybe babies one day, and love. Cheers.
Good evening. As some of you know, my name is Erin. Patrick and I have been best friends for the last 17 years. And that's easy to say now, but the first time that we actually met, we were picking him up from the airport, myself with a few friends who actually already had met him. And he's on the phone with someone saying, yeah, I'm in the car with so-and-so, so-and-so, and stuff. And from then, I was like, okay, I don't think I'm gonna like this guy. But somehow, through our sarcasm, we became great friends, and the rest is history. I am grateful that he asked me to be his maid of honor in such an important occasion in his life. Over the years, I've pretty much seen and heard it all from him, but I'm not gonna air any of that right now. Maybe you can see me later. But what I will say is that most of you get to see a more serious, confident side of Patrick, and I've been lucky enough to see the other thoughtful and sweet side. He lived in Arizona, I lived in California, so in our teenage years, he would write me letters and write me long cards and send me all these kind of mail, and it'd be so sweet because we didn't get to see each other very often, and it meant the world to me. Back then, it was really expensive for long-distance calling, so we both had to pay some expensive bills a few times, and I know that you remember those times. It makes me incredibly happy that he has met someone as caring, patient, understanding, and funny as Alvin to spend the rest of his future with. Their personalities complement each other with ease and perfection. And I've been lucky enough over the years to watch their love grow, as many of you have as well. Alvin and Patrick, I wish you a lifetime of laughter, love, and endless success. Please raise your glasses for the lovely couple to Alvin and Patrick.
Hi, my name is Kit. Hi, my name is Kit. I'm Pat's best friend for almost 10 years now. I'm really nervous, by the way, because I don't do this. So Pat has been a great friend to me, and he's always been there whenever I need him, and whatever issue that I've had or whatever ex-boyfriend I had. So Pat and Alvin has always given me a good advice with my personal life and my career as well. So I really appreciate you guys being my friend, and that I'm not a man of many words, so I'm gonna keep you short. But I'm so glad you're in my life, and and I really, I feel honored to be your best man. So have a cheers to that, because I'm happy for you guys.
Jomar. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jomar. So I've known Patrick for a really long time. So I've known Patrick for a really long time, and he's always been one of my really, really down friends. Down to do anything, down to go on a random trip. Whenever I broke up with a boyfriend, I would be like, hey, Patrick, let's go to LA. And he'd come to LA with me. New Year's Eve, all my best friends are in a relationship, so I'm the last one standing, FYI. And I was like, Patrick, I don't have plans for New Year's. Let's go to Vegas together. And he's always there with me. And as some of my friends know, I'm pretty type A and I'm uptight and I like to follow the rules. And the reason why I like Patrick is he shows me how to appreciate life. And one story I can tell you is we were at a club once and we were dancing and next to a table, and then all of a sudden there's bottle service. And I go, Patrick, there's bottle service here. Where did this come from? He goes, I don't know. My mom bought it for me. Who cares? Just drink it. So, to me, that just shows, like, Patrick is just, he just shows me how to enjoy life, and if a random bottle appears, enjoy it and take a shot of someone else's bottle. And then to Alvin. I had this moment where I asked Patrick, I was like, so when did you know that Alvin was the one? And he told me, he said, Alvin is smart, he's driven, he's close to his family, and he makes me a better person. And I think all of us here as people, we strive to find our equal, and I'm so happy that you guys found your equal. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. My name is Chris Cole.
No, but seriously, so Patrick and I have known each other since we were about 16. 5 years ago. It's actually really funny how we met. Patrick was living in Arizona, I was in California, and Patrick saw it necessary to drive all the way to California to confront me because he thought I was trying to steal his boyfriend. And I was not, for the record. I think it was great that Patrick and I met at such like a weird, awkward stage. We were 16, and I mean, I know a lot of you guys know, but like, as if that age wasn't awkward enough, it's even more awkward for people like us. And by people like us, I mean like really pretty people. And Patrick, just by our relationship, you helped to make me feel more comfortable with who I am at that age. Being fabulous. Patrick is one of my most favorite people in the world, and Alvin, you have been nothing but kind and sweet and so nice to all of us, and I couldn't be happier that one of my favorite people in the world has someone like you to take care of him for the rest of his life. So thank you so much. If we could all raise a glass. To Alvin and Patrick, congratulations. Yes, go on.
Hello, everyone, and good evening. My name is Will.
My name is Jonathan.
And I'm Jeff.
We are privileged and honored to be Alvin's best man.
So to describe Alvin in like three words, it would be...
driven.
Smart.
And a lot of fun. It's always good times with Alvin, whether it's random nights out in the city or traveling halfway across the world. If there was a picture in the dictionary under work hard, play hard, it would be that of Alvin's.
All jokes aside, Alvin is driven not only because he went to med school, but he also helped start a clinic serving the Filipino community in San Francisco.
And Alvin, he also graduated at Cal and UCSF with honors.
And throughout his busy schedule, he managed to develop lifelong relationships with his friends. And we, Jonathan, Will, were lucky enough to be one of those people.
But Alvin wouldn't be anything he is today without the help of Patrick,
who's equally as...
driven,
smart,
and a lot of fun.
So to Alvin and Patrick, we wish you guys the love of happiness.
The gift of love.
and a lot more bijoux.
To you, my son, Alvin, you mean the world to me. You know that. You have been my strength, my pride and joy. I don't want to cry. I don't want you to cry either. All through these years, and you will always be my precious baby, my perfect son, and the perfect brother to Annalise and Ariel. I wish you and Patrick the best of everything. I wish you success and abundant life. I wish you love, joy, and happiness through all the years that you will be together. I love you both. And I'm always going to be the mother that will give everything for you and your sisters. Cheers for both of you.
About a year ago when this song came out, I remember when it was playing on the radio, Alvin said, at our wedding, it would be amazing if you were to sing this song for me. And I knew he was trying to drop hints, so just a little bit. So I'm actually going to sing this song. It's Ed Sheeran, Think Out Loud.
Remember the taste of my love. Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? 'Cause darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And maybe my heart could still fall as hard at 23. Maybe it's all
Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never feel those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do.
Well, let's clap it up for them, clap it up.
Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Everybody, let's clap it up for Alvin, Patrick, and their moms, Elsie.
So me and Alvin want to thank everybody for taking time out of their holiday weekend to come out here, especially all of our guests coming from out of town, all over the country. Can I hear it? Scream if you're from out of town. Scream if you're from New York. Okay, where? The West Coast?
LA.
Wait, LA? Arizona?
Hawaii.
Zimbabwe? I'm just kidding.
Hawaii.
Okay, where else?
Philippines? San Francisco! Yeah!
But really, we want to thank everybody who's here. We love all of you. I want to say a special shout out to my family who flew in from Arizona, my mother and father who are the most... Hello, stand up. You guys are the most supportive parents anyone could ever ask for. I love you so much. And I'm so happy that you guys are here. My brothers from Arizona, I love you. Alvin's sisters and his mother for making it out here as well. We love you. Okay, I know you want to say something. Do you want to say something?
It fills our hearts to see all of you guys here. We have... Like we said earlier, we have worked with you, we've gone to school with you guys, we have partied with you guys, a little too much with some of you guys, right? But it means the world to us that you guys took time out of your busy schedules to be here in New York, Memorial Day weekend. And we are just filled with joy and our hearts are warm and we are truly, truly grateful. Thank you so much.
Okay, let's party.
Hallelujah. Girl, sit you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk.